guys, today I'm going to be doing a Sephora haul. Let me just say a crazy story. This is the first haul that I've uploaded in 5 months. What? 5 months. I don't know which is crazier, the fact that I haven't uploaded a haul in 5 months or the fact that I haven't gone makeup shopping in 5 months. Like, so weird. But I honestly just got to a point in late September where I was like, I'm satisfied, I'm good, I have more than enough makeup, I'm a little overwhelmed to be quite honest. So the past few months I have just enjoyed my collection and been telling myself that I don't need more. And because, you know, you constantly feel like you need more all the time, no matter what area of life it is. And I'm trying to just be satisfied with what I currently have. So that's what I've been doing for the past few months. I've given tons of makeup away. It's been a weight off my chest. So after 5 months of not shopping, I did some damage. You already know I did some damage today. I will be doing an updated makeup collection soon. There's a lot of makeup back there, so you guys can be overwhelmed with me. That will be coming up in the next few weeks. It felt so good to be back in Candyland today. Yes. Let's see here. This is it. This is my whole receipt. This looks like I bought nothing. Are you kidding? I was hoping for some like badass receipt that I could be like, boom, but no, of course. It's like, what is this? Let's do this. First thing I got, which is not even something that I wanted to get, I was like, ugh, I didn't even want to spend my money on this, but I had to get another Essence Yaki perfume. I talked about this in my most recent favorites, and the cap is broken and it shoots perfume out everywhere and it's a hot mess, so I just had to get a new one because the cap was broken. I hate spending money on things I don't actually like. You know what I'm saying? It's like, why did the cap break? Then I picked up two of the newer shades from the Too Faced Melted Liquefied Long Wear Lipstick Collection. These originally came out months back and I really liked the formulation of them, but the colors were very bold and very bright, and I typically am not a bold lip kind of gal on the day to day. I typically like my neutrals and my nudes and my pinks and those type of shades. So I was super excited when I saw that these were coming out. I actually haven't even swatched them yet because Sephora was madness today and I didn't even have time to swatch these in the store, so I actually have no idea what they look like, so you're gonna get to see them with me for the first time. Okay, let me see. Please be pretty, please be pretty. I don't wanna have to return you. Oh my god, I die. Okay, so Melted Sugar so far is freaking gorgeous. Like, I love that. And this one is called Melted Chihuahua. Okay, that's kind of wrong. Melted Chihuahua? Like, what? No. Oh, that is so pretty. I thought it was gonna be a little bit more rosy, but this is still so pretty. So that is Melted Sugar, and that is Melted Chihuahua. I don't even wanna say that. Melted Chihuahua, like, is it anybody else feeling that that's disturbing? Tons of you guys have been tweeting me about this new Tint In Oil YSL Nourishing Lip Oil Color Enhancer. I really don't know what it is, but because so many of you have been tweeting me, telling me that I need to get it, I just trusted you and I was like, okay. And I got the color I Rose You. Oh, that's cute. I don't know what it does, so I can't tell you, because like I said, Sephora was so crazy today that I did not have time to do anything. Like, I was just grabbing things, like throwing it in my basket. There were so many people. It was just such madness. It feels like straight up oil. I'll get back to you and let you know how I feel, but I'm excited that it's called the Tint In Oil, because anything that's nourishing, moisturizing, oily, I'm all about that life. I ordered this one online, and this is another YSL product. Oh my god, so much money. Just like, as I'm pointing these out, I'm like, why did we spend this much money again? This is the YSL Glossy Stain in number 18. I don't know if this is new, but in my mind it's new, so I needed it. And it just looks so pretty. I love these glossy stains, but I only have, I think, two of them because, hello, they're YSL, they are expensive. You're barely gonna be able to see it on the back of my hand, I bet, right there. I have noticed that swatching them does not show up as much on the hand as they do on the lips. Now, because this is a pale color, I don't know if this is gonna show up much on the lips at all, but the other two that I have, I absolutely love them. They're glossy and they are stained, so it's just very different, and I love the way they wear. But they are super similar to the L'Oreal stains from the drugstore, I will say. Like, I honestly wouldn't spend your money on this if you're like debating it. Go to the drugstore and get the L'Oreal ones because they are super, super similar. Just being honest. And then I got another YSL product. I told you I did some damage. This is the Voluptuous Sheer Candy, and I have two of these and I love them. I will put these on when I'm not wearing makeup because they're super sheer, and I just like this color because it's very mauve-y, and you'll see as I put it on, like, that just barely any color shows up, and I just really like these for days when you're not wearing makeup, or let's say you're wearing barely any makeup and you don't want to do like a bold lip, but you just want a little color. These are like ideal. I love them, and I don't know of anyone else that has this formulation or anything close, which you have to pay an arm and a leg in order to get this, but I've looked for other companies that make something similar to this, which is a very sheer wash of color and very moisturizing, and I can't find it. So I love these. This is my third color that I own, and I've almost gone through the first two because they're just so perfect for when you don't want a bold lip. So Marc Jacobs reformulated their lipsticks. Ah, hallelujah, because I tried one of his lipsticks when his line first came out, and I was like, but today when I went in, my friend Marissa, she works at my Sephora, so she always like takes me around and shows me what's new, tells me what's great, tells me what's not worth it, and she told me that this was worth it. So Marissa, I trust you. So I got the shade Strange Magic from Marc Jacobs, and it says on the box, Marc Jacobs New Nudes Sheer Lip Gel. So I'm excited to try this. The packaging looks like this. It's like a very interesting color, honestly. It's like a very, I'm gonna be honest, blasé kind of baby barf nude, but that's okay. I'm not judging the packaging because what's on the inside looks gorgeous. Do you see this beautiful baby pink? So I picked this one up because you know I love my pinks, and anytime I try a new collection or a new makeup line, I always go for the neutrals because I know neutrals, it's what I love, it's what I wear all the time, so I feel like I can really judge a formula by trying the neutrals first. So it looks like this right here on the back of the hand. It's a beautiful baby pink, and it says that it's a gel, and it definitely feels different. It feels very moisturizing. It has pretty much like no scent at all. I got the new Naked, the new Urban Decay Naked Skin Weightless Complete Coverage Concealer. I am super excited to try this. I actually ordered this online when it first came out, and I ordered it in the lightest shade. I don't know why. And when it got to my house, it was so white. I was like, oh my gosh. Like, it was very, very light. So I went back today and I got light neutral. So yeah, that looks much, much better. Much more like my color right there, because I like my concealer to be a little bit lighter than my foundation, but not too much lighter. And the consistency feels like I might fall in love, and I'm a little excited about this. Ooh, and it smells like a product I'm gonna like. I'm so weird, I know. But just the way it feels like jelly. It feels cool, I'm excited to try it. These two purchases are quite expensive, but I was talked into getting them from my friend, so I was like, fine. And this one is the Fresh Black Tea Firming Overnight Mask. It says it's with soothing Belle du Nut. Okay, nope, I can't pronounce that. Anyways, this is supposed to be anti-aging, and it's like an overnight mask, but it feels more like a moisturizer on the skin. I love the black tea facial mask. I bought that last year, over a year ago, and I have been loving it for a long time. So I'm really, really excited to try this because I love the mask so much, and I love the idea of keeping something on my face all night long. I'm all about sleeping in masks and overnight masks. I think they really do make a difference, as opposed to like a 5 to 10 minute mask where I don't typically see a very big difference in my skin. I am so excited about this. This is like the number one thing that I'm most excited about in this entire haul. No, that's a lie, but I am really excited about this. This is the Peter Thomas Roth 24 karat gold mask. My friend Marissa told me that this makes a very big difference in your skin, and it really gives you a beautiful luminous glow afterwards, and it's supposed to be anti-aging. Like, it's intense. It's intense. I'm excited to put this on and be like, hey, go member, hey, go member. I'm just saying, if you're a true fan of Beyonce, you know all about that gold member life. Then I picked up two different contour kits. This is the Smashbox Step-by-Step Contour Kit. I love the Smashbox Step-by-Step Contour Sticks that are the creams. I have been crazy, crazy into cream contouring and cream bronzing recently, like the past month and a half. It's all I've been doing. I will have a video on that very soon. So I also wanted to try the Smashbox Step-by-Step Contour Kit. I feel like contour kits have been coming out every single week. Anastasia started a huge trend, I believe, with her contour kit, and now tons of people are doing it. So I have been pretty much buying all of them because I want to get the feel for them and get the feel for what's best so I can stick with that one. And then I got the Laura Mercier Flawless Contour Palette, and this is cream. So I'm super excited about this right here. It looks like that. So you have different shades. I'm going to set this on my chin. You have different shades to contour with right there. And then you have this little highlighting color as well. So they are all creams. There are no powders in this, but I really like these three shades. I would definitely be this first one right here to contour with, but I just think this is exciting. So I'm excited to try this because, like I said, I'm all about cream contour recently. I'm like addicted right now. Then I got the CoverFX Illuminating Face Primer because I have had a sick obsession with face primers recently. For the past couple of months, I've been trying every single face primer like under the sun because I just want to find something that truly makes a difference. And right now I am loving the Smashbox Primer Water and also the Smashbox Hydrating Primer. But I'm just always looking for something that is really gonna make a difference. And I've tried the popular ones like the Benefit Professional and the Tarte one, and I didn't see, but my issue isn't pores. So a lot of those that work for everyone else with the whole pore filling issue, that's not really what I'm looking for. But once I find a primer that is like, I will let you know. I got the Urban Decay Naked Skin Ultra Definition Powder Foundation. I got this because I'm always looking for powders to set my T-zone area. I a lot of times will use a highlighting powder, or I'll get a powder that's a foundation and buy a shade or two lighter because I like that area to be a little bit lighter, like that, and underneath my eyes, just for a more naturally defined highlighted look. But I wanted to try this powder just because I was feeling it in Sephora, and it just feels so creamy and the coverage looks incredible. So I did get this in my shade as opposed to a highlighting shade because I just want to try it. I used to use the MAC Mineralize Skin Finish all the time to set that area, but that can sometimes break up on me. Even though I love that it has like a nice glowy effect, sometimes it just breaks up and just does not look good after a few hours. So that's why I picked up that. Just a little baby. I got the Kat Von D Everlasting Face Shaper Blush, and this is in the shade Heartogram. This color is super different from anything I own, at least that's how I feel, and I think that it's so pretty. It has a nice shimmer in it, and it's just a really pretty, like, rosy, purpley. Ooh, I love that. Isn't that so pretty? So much coverage, and the shimmer in it is just gorgeous. I'm super picky about my blushes and the way the shimmer looks, because I don't like it to look frosty or glittery. It has to have just, like, a nice sheen, and this is just gorgeous. So I just felt like it was necessary in my collection because I don't own anything like that. And then, last but not least, I came home to this bad boy waiting for me at my front door, and I was so excited. This is the new Anastasia Beverly Hills Contour Cream Series, and I haven't even opened it up yet because I wanted to open it on camera because I'm so excited to try it. So it has three different palettes right here with all contour cream colors. This is like heaven to me right now. And like, look at all the different shades in there for different skin tones. Oh my god, I'm so excited. So I would be the light one. I'm sure I would be the light one. Oh my god, I'm so excited. Look how pretty. Oh my god. Oh my gosh, look at this. Look at this. Oh my god, I'm so excited. Oh, these feel nice. Oh my god. Yes. I am so excited right now. Oh my gosh. Look at how nice this blends. I'll pick up the darkest color and the lightest palette, and I'll show you how it blends out. Like, you can see how it's nice and creamy. Ooh, yes. So nice. I'm so excited to try these. I will be using these when I do my makeup tomorrow. I can't wait. I've been so excited for these to launch. I don't even know when they launch exactly. I know that they sent them out to everybody today, like on their PR list, all like the Instagrammers and YouTubers. So that's why everybody is getting them today and posting pictures and stuff like that. So I'm super excited. I'm sure you guys will be seeing me using these in tutorials coming soon. So that is the end of my Sephora haul. I hope that you guys enjoy. I'm sure this is a very long video, but it's been so long that, you know, I'm going to Sephora and having it be so busy and chaotic there. Like, I was just like, oh, it's too much pressure. And I was just like buying everything in sight. So I'm excited though. I love new products so much. I can't wait to like play with everything and just like set it up. When I get new makeup, I like set it up in my vanity for like 2 days. And I just walk in and I'm like, hi. I'm such a dork, but seriously, I just love products and I love makeup. So yeah, I hope that you guys enjoy. I do have to say before I go that I have a long list that I'm making the past couple of days of videos that I want to do for the next month or two. Ideas that I have in mind for makeup tutorials and different videos. I want to do a question and answer. I want to do like a more personal video and open up about some things that I've gone through, and I want to do a makeup collection video. So if you guys have any suggestions for videos or makeup tutorials or specific colors you want to see, go ahead and leave those down below, and I will be reading comments and of course take your suggestions into mind and make a list, you know, around what you guys would like to see. So I will be doing makeup tutorials with the Jaclyn Hill Morphe palette very, very soon. It will be coming up in the next week or so. I know you guys have been waiting a long time, so I will be pumping those out very soon. So yeah, I hope that you guys enjoy this video. Thank you so much for watching. I love you guys, and I'll see you soon. Bye. Then I picked up two contour... So I hope that you enjoy, and I here, let's zoom you in. Say hi. Are you sleepy? Are you sleepy, buddy? Yeah. Oi. How can I breathe without you? I'm very nervous. Disclaimer right now, I'm scared that I'm gonna get lipstick on my teeth. You get it together. Georgie's looking at me like, get it together right now. Get it together. This is. Haven't even dug into the bag and I'm already sick of hearing my own voice. Get it together. Well, like, I have so... No! Oh my gosh, Georgie is snoring like a bitch. I've bought in, like... Hey guys! No, you just scared your audience.